You know, it could have been anybody, a deacon or somebody. But it's a pastor, and it's so appropriate. That's what's sad. Because the story is real close to home for me. I can't tell you how many Christmas programs I've been to, how many times I've heard the story, how many times I've preached on the story. But can I tell you that it can become so common that it loses the wonder? It loses the significance. And it's almost like what I like to say is that the holy becomes common. It's no big deal, but it's a huge deal. In fact, I had the privilege of having my mom here tonight. She is from Little Rock, Arkansas. She's seated right back there with my family. And I grew up in the church. I was born on the third row of the Baptist church. That's where I spent all my life. That's all I know. And so I can't tell you how many times I've been around the holy things. But I can remember for years they didn't mean anything. And then I remember when it became more than just a Christmas book. It became a personal story. It became my story. Because there was a moment in my life where I realized he did this for me. That this story of Jesus coming to this earth and a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, this was for me. He came that he could take my sin, and he came to give me a second chance. So I could start over. And it was that moment, it was then, that I realized this is more than just a program. Tonight, we want you to know it's so much more than just a program. This is the gospel. This is what God has done for you. That's why this song, come and see what he's done. The greatest way to see what he's done is through a person in heaven. And I just believe that for any one of us in this room, we can start over. I don't know, you may be doing great with your life on your own. But I wasn't, and I know many that, no, on our own. The Bible says we're all sinners. We need a Savior. So there comes that point where you realize, you know what, I can't fix me. I can't do it alone. I need Christ. I need Christ for my life. I need him for my marriage. I need him for relationships and work. And it's just that's why he came. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes, they will not perish, but have everlasting life. He came that we might have life, and not just life, but life abundant. So if there's anyone in this room tonight that the story's familiar, but it's just a story, we want it to be real tonight for the first time. We want to invite you to come and see what. Put your personal faith and trust in Christ and say, honestly, God, forgive me. I want to start over. I want a second chance. For some of you, you remember the day that this was more than a story. You remember a moment in your life when you trusted Christ as your Savior and you followed him. But then a lot of things happen. Life happens. And you get away from it. And you walk away from the faith. You didn't need to. You didn't start out with that in mind. Maybe on a night like this, it's a wonderful time to come back. If you're not to see a conclusion where the pastor is transformed. Can pastors really be transformed? Yes, they can. And so can you. I just want to pray for you. I want to bow your heads together. I'm going to invite you. I want you to just make it personal right now, Lord, especially if you're here tonight. You've never personally said, Jesus, I need you. I want you to come in my life. I want to know you. I want to start over. I need you. I want to lead you in a simple prayer. The Bible says, whoever calls on the name of the Lord, they shall be saved. So I believe you